So how did you go about, finding those first clients?
Well, I must say, I didn't go out and find them. They were mostly referred to me by my mother, my father, my friends. One advantage that I had when I got out of law school was that most people back then in the middle 70s, after they got out of law school and passed the bar, everybody went and worked for somebody. State attorney's office, public defender's office, attorney general's office, small firms, big firms.
Black ones, brown ones, rich ones, poor ones, crazy ones. Spill the wine! Dig that girl!
No.
Spill the wine!
Whatever it may be, corporate, it really didn't matter. And so I found myself as being the only one of all of my classmates that I knew that had opened their own practice. And so I made that fact known to everyone, all of my friends from law school and what have you, all my contacts from law school. And the business started trickling in. And as the business starts trickling in and you do a good job, then word gets out and that's essentially is the genesis of my law practice. I also got lucky a little bit in that I had, like, for example, one of the South Florida's premier roofing companies. Their office assistant was calling, looking for a lawyer by the name of Wolf that he had been referred to. Of course, I wasn't the one that he was referred to, but we got into a nice discussion and he said, "Do you do this kind of law? Do you know how mechanics liens and this, that, and the other thing?" "Sure, I know everything." Right? So that's how I acquired that client. And then I had one of the biggest credit unions down here in South Florida. I was handling like a small house closing for somebody. I didn't know how to do closings, and the credit union had a lien on the property, and so I had to clear that up. So I wound up calling the credit union and talking to the general manager. And right at the end of the conversation, he says, "Oh, by the way, do you do banking law?" And I'm like, "Sure. What do you want to know?" And so he said, "Well, we can't seem to get in touch with our lawyer, and we got three hearings in the morning, and we don't know what to do." And I said, "Send me over the documents. I'll show up in court for you." And I did, and I was successful on all three hearings somehow or another. And they became my client for the next 15 years or so. So that's how things can get started. You need a little luck. Never hurts, right? You need to be in the right place at the right time. You need to have a good knack for selling yourself, for convincing potential clients that you have the expertise and know how to handle their matter and that you care about their matter. You need to be very diligent when you're returning phone calls and messages and what have you. One of the biggest things that I learned, and I did reading and all that kind of stuff there were some very good books on how to manage a law office and how to keep and attract clients. And I took a lot of that advice to heart. For example, sitting next to somebody on an airplane and you just talking to them about this, that, or the other thing, and the plane lands, and usually you just say goodbye and good luck, right? But I would never do that without giving them a business card, right? In case you're ever in need. I mean, that's just one example. Sending Christmas cards every year to your clients or having some kind of promotion and what have you. You want your clients to know that you care and that you think about them, all right? And that is, I would have to say that through the course of my career, and I'm lucky that I learned that early in my career, but that to me is priority number one. The number one thing that people look for in their lawyer is somebody who cares about them, is responsive to them. Yeah, it's nice if you get them good results, but a lot of times you may not get the best result, and the client's still going to like you because they understand that not every lawyer wins every case, obviously, but they have a good, a sense of warmth towards you. that they're not afraid to call you again, right? On the other hand, if you're not responsive and you're not attentive to your clients, right, then usually they're going to have a problem with calling you again. And if you happen to get a bad result for them, then, you know, you're never going to hear from them again, right? And but if you demonstrate that you care about your client, that you're responsive to your client, then word gets out about that as well. And that's how things mushroom into a successful law practice from that little beginning. So were these tips helpful or what? These are the kinds of videos that we're going to be doing in the future. Maybe once a week, maybe twice a week, maybe 5 times a week, maybe 15 times a week. Who knows? I like being in front of the camera, as you can tell. We want you to subscribe below to our YouTube channel, and you can follow us on our social media links right below. Start right now. We want you to know that here at Michael Howard Wolf Law Firm, and especially me, we are always on your side.